Hi guys, it's Sean the Silver Fox, and I know what a lot of you are going to be saying to me is, where's your hat? Well, my hat's back in the car, and because I was bringing all those knives out for one of the early videos, I had a rucksack with kit that I'm doing reviews for, and had a shoulder bag with all my knives in it, and I just forgot to pick it up. So I apologise, but I don't really want to walk back out up to where the car is, because it's quite a walk up a big hill to get to it. The location I've chosen is down in a valley, a little sort of glen in a woodland area, to try and get me out of the wind, because in the UK now we've got quite a lot of strong winds. So and I always get complaints about the wind noise, and I'm using I'll show you, I'm using a microphone which mounts to the top of the camera. It's got a big windsock on it, so hopefully that's going to reduce the wind noise. So I'm using the bigger camera, the HD camera. A bit more work for me when I come to process them, because I have to convert all the files and nonsense like that. Anyway, so that's why I haven't got my hat. But this video, it's to do with this tool here, okay? This sheath I made myself. I'm quite proud of this sheath, actually, because when you see the tool, to get a sheath that fitted it, as you can see, it's an unusual shape. So what this tool came around from was when I'm out doing wild food walks and stuff, and I was using my knives for digging up roots and getting tubers out of the ground and that sort of stuff, and every now and again I'd chip the tip of the blade, and you know, I'd have to keep repolishing them and sharpening and that sort of stuff. And I spoke to Chris, and I kept talking about I want a foraging tool, a tool designed for foraging. So when I was up there in April, he made one for me. Now he made one for me, and then I made one for a friend of mine. So, but this one Chris made for me. So what it is have a piece of round bar, and then we forged it and to a point with a slight claw on the end, and then the other end was hammered flat with a chisel point. So what this tool then gives me is, this chisel point here is for digging up in grass and soft ground. I can, like, it's almost like a little spade, you can just dig up. Chisel point there, you know, if I need it for scraping and that sort of stuff, okay? The pointy end here is for stony ground. So if I'm digging up stuff like silverweed, for example, okay, it likes compacted ground. But I can use this, and I can sort of dig in there, scrape the soil away to get to reveal the roots. A bit of a mission to do for stuff like burdock. You know, I'd normally just get a stick, sharpen a stick and use that. But for small stuff, this is convenient. Also, this edge is I use for striking the ferro rod. And it's something I've, over time, has dawned on me. And it was particularly when I was using the Silver Fox Cub. Let me just get the blade for you. Particularly when using this little cub knife. Now the knife is, as I've shown before in other videos, you know, it's a nice mirror polish on this blade to reduce the rusting. But what I was finding when I was using a ferro rod across the back here, I was getting like little black marks down the back here and like little burrs on the edge of the back of the knife. And you know, I really like this knife, like super like it. And I really want to sort of, I just want to keep it as pristine as I can. Although I use it, you know, I use this knife, I guarantee you I use this knife every weekend. Okay, if I'm, well, I use this knife, if I'm going out in the woods, this knife is always on me. If I'm just going out for a short walk, if I'm taking a group out for a 3-hour wild food foray, I'll have this knife on me. I may not take the SFK, don't need it for a, you know, a walk. If I'm doing any sort of anything as a campfire and need firewood, then this is always on me. But if it's not, it's this one. And you might have, anyway, we'll talk about the other sheath another day. So, we had this knife made. So what this foraging tool then is my striker. And it's become a really, really useful tool. And the more and more I use it, the better it's come. I had the hole put in the end here because I thought it might be handy. But to be honest, I don't use it for anything. So don't need the hole. But what I will get put into it next time will be a little bottle opener on the side here. Now, I don't drink a lot of beer and stuff like that. I'm not a big drinker, I should say. But it would just be handy to have it, I think. Adrian, who's a friend of mine who's got the other one of these, he does a lot more fungi foraging than I do. And what he's asked is to have a cutting edge on this end here, like a dull cutting edge. So when he can use it like this for just cutting through the stems of fungi, just cutting them open. So that might be the other variations. We'll put maybe a cutting edge on one profile. But this is, I wanted to share this with you. We're calling this the Silver Fox Claw. Again, it's made for me. It's not made as a production tool, but it's a really handy tool to have. And I think I'm going to make a couple of prototypes with some other ideas I've got. Like I said, about the cutting edge, the bottle opener, and that sort of stuff. And if I get one that's perfect, then I'll look at getting these made. But why hasn't anyone thought of it before? It's really, really, really useful tool. So there you go, that's a Silver Fox Claw. Okay, claw because it's claw-like, and because when we are digging in the ground like this and we're scraping the stony ground, it's like having claws. It's just like that. So thanks, guys. Short video, a bit rambling, that's not nonsense, and you know, but I said guys again. So it's a bad habit I've got to get into. Do you know, I'm going to blame Mike Dixon because he says guys all the time, so I reckon it's his fault. So no offence, Mike, if you're watching, no offence, mate. But it's a habit I've noticed I've been doing, and I've got to get out of doing it. So thanks, folks, and I'll see you on the next video. And why am I looking at the camera?